should we call obesity a disease? The argument to do so, as purported by numerous large organizations currently, notably the American Medical Association, is we'll achieve two things. The first is kind of related to the legal and medical system of the US. The idea is that calling it a disease will increase the attention that insurance companies and medical companies and the government pay to obesity and devote more care to it, because obesity is currently the second leading cause of preventable death in the world. Only tobacco ranks higher, and it is probably a matter of time before obesity takes over the number one spot. I'm not going to go into that in too much detail. Rather, I'm going to focus on the second reason, which is that calling obesity a disease is supposed to reduce weight stigma. And a new study that's just been done finds that this is indeed the case. The study concluded pathologizing obesity may reinforce biogenetic explanations for obesity. Biogenetic causal beliefs were associated with less weight stigma. So pathologizing obesity, basically calling obesity a disease, making it a pathology, may reinforce biogenetic explanations for obesity. So it basically makes people think that obesity is something that's caused by your biology and your genetics. And that in turn reduces weight stigma, because it's something essentially, by calling it the disease, people think of it more as a biological genetic thing, like some people can't help it, and therefore that reduces weight stigma. And so the authors basically use that as an argument to say it's good to call people or to say that people with obesity have a disease. However, when I see biogenetic causal beliefs, that I immediately think of previous research, which found very different things, or very adverse effects of calling obesity a disease. They specifically found that across three experimental studies, we highlighted the potential hidden costs associated with labeling obesity as a disease, showing that this message, presented in an actual New York Times article, undermined beneficial weight loss self-regulatory processes. So basically, calling obesity a disease reduced people's weight loss efforts. A disease-based, relative to an information-based, weight management message weakens the importance placed on health-focused dieting and reduced concerns about weight among obese individuals, the very people whom such public health messages are targeting. So basically, they're saying that when you call it a disease, it makes it seem like something that's just happened to you, something you can't do anything about, and therefore it also reduces people with obesity's efforts to get leaner. Further, the decreased concern about weight predicted higher calorie food choices. This is important. It actually shows that when you say this is a disease, it directly alters people's healthy eating behaviors. In addition, the disease message, relative to a message that obesity is not a disease, lowered body image dissatisfaction, but this too predicted higher calorie food choices. And this is, again, very important, because basically, they're saying that when you call obesity a disease, it makes people with obesity feel better about themselves, but the fact that they feel better about themselves also reduces their efforts to get leaner. Thus, although defining obesity as a disease may be beneficial for body image, results from the current work emphasize the negative implications of this message for self-regulation. So, when we call obesity a disease, we have to wonder, who are we intending to help? Are we calling obesity a disease to make people with obesity feel better about themselves? Or are we calling obesity a disease to make other people feel better about us because we're so virtuous? And do we have in mind the actual well-being of the people of obese individuals? Because are we more concerned with them feeling good about themselves, or are we more concerned with helping them get leaner? Now, in my view, I don't care. I don't, for my clients, my students, I don't care about how we call it. I never have a client and I'm like, okay, you have a disease or you have a disorder. No. The way I see it is all the focus on semantics is just semantics. Words we use. Words matter. They influence our psychology, as these studies show. But actions are much more important. So the way I see it, when I have a client, I say, you currently have body fat percentage X. What is your goal? You want body fat percentage Y. Okay, so what do we need to do to get your body fat percentage from your goal to this level? That's what's important. And anything that aids that message that helps them get to their goal and makes them achieve their goal is good, in my view, as a coach, as a consultant, as an educator. So personally, I feel that in our society, we are being very, very concerned about word choices and tolerance and empathy towards others at the expense of actual goal-directed action. The important thing is that we say, look, many people are overweight these days. More than 2 out of 3 people are overweight. More than 1 out of 3 people is obese. It's projected by 2030, over half the population is going to be obese. So literally, obesity is going to be the new normal. Now, I don't care if you call it a disorder, pathology, or just a body fat percentage. People with obesity almost universally want to get leaner. Not all of them, and people that don't, great. You know, if you don't want to get leaner, you're happy with your body, great. But many people with obesity, the vast majority in research, not only wants to get leaner, but actually engages in weight loss efforts. And to those individuals, I would say it is most important that we actually help them achieve their goals rather than focus on all of this semantic wordplay. So in this sense, in the context of a fitness or a health professional working with a client one-to-one, I would say it is not a good idea to call obesity a disease, but rather to emphasize the power you have over your own body fat percentage and to say, look, you have a current body fat percentage, you want it to be something else, I can help you get to that point, here's how we're going to do it.